Today's topic is the gift of opportunity. Today's topic is the gift of opportunity. I'm going to deliver God's message, this topic. Today is the Lord's Day. We need to think deeply what our God has done, a lot of things for us over 1 year. And we need to thank God. Psalms 50, verse 23. He who sacrifices thank offerings honors me, and he prepares the way so that I may show him the salvations of God. There are two effects from when we thank God in this verse. The first one is that it makes him honor, and the next one is that we receive the salvations of God. There are benefits for God and us. We need to see the summer essence of gospel. After his resurrection, he came to Peter. There are two things we can see. The first one is that Jesus gave another chance to Peter. The second one is that Peter felt sorry for Jesus. But Jesus came to Peter and he allowed Peter to say something. Gratitude is related to our mission. Now, we are going to see through each point. The first one is that I really thank God that he gives me a second chance. I'll give you an example. There is an inexperienced junior in the church. His senior was away for a few weeks. So the junior needed to preach a sermon instead of the senior. The young junior was really nervous, and he didn't know what message he needed to deliver. At the time, there was a famous senior pastor coming. He heard the news. In the sermon, the famous pastor said, "There is a woman whom has the warm heart I have hugged." Most church members in the church were confused and looked shocked that the pastor said, "It is my mother." When the church members heard his saying, they were surprised and they listened a lot of graceful message. The sermon was about God's love and mother's love. It was an impressive sermon. The junior wrote down on the note, then he decided to follow the famous pastor's message. Actually, the church he belonged to is like a traditional church. In the church, most church members are old men or female. On the sermon day, the junior preached and asked, "There is a woman who has the warm heart. I have a heart." Church members in the church were confused and looked shocked. Then he said, "It is suddenly he forgot the next word. Also, he was lost his note." When he looked at the church members, they were wondering who he is. Then he said, "I do not remember. The sermon was not great." Later, the senior came and explained all church members to understand him. The senior gave him the second chance to do again. People make a lot of mistakes and failures. We are sinners. When someone forgives him or her, this means that the person takes another chance to recover. We can be saved when we forgive others. This can be the second chance to us. We are so weak. We can make a lot of mistakes and failures. But when we receive forgiveness from others, we can recover and then we can rise again. We need to thank God who gives us another chance. Today, we must thank God and we must say, "Thank God you gave me the second chance. So I can do whatever you want." Now, from today's passage, Peter, who has the first one of apostles, denied Jesus.
그런데 부활의 주님께서 베드로 만나 가지고 하신
John chapter 21 verse 15. When they have finished eating, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon son of John, do you truly love me more than that I love you? Jesus said, feed my lambs. He repeated three times. He gave Peter the mission. Jesus said, feed my lambs. He gave Peter his mission. Like Jesus, we need to give him another chance to others. When you have a second chance, we can do his missions. So what do we do? We must give others the second chance to do more. I'll ask you one question. It is easy for us to have the discipline or have a test. Some people say that it is a discipline, while others argue that it is the test. In Korea, most young people have a toy test.
100명 정도가 시험을 봅니다. 하루면 끝나죠. 시험 문제 출제하고 난 다음에 시험 보게
Which is kind of English test to check English ability. In the test, the standard score is 700 out of
990.
When some people pass the score, they say they are passed, but if they do not, they say they are failed. But this score cannot be judged by the others' judgment. If there are many different types of English level tests, it would take more than 3 or 4 years. It might be more than 10 years. For somebody, church should be a place for discipline. Some people act like curses. They try to follow the rules of church and focus on their righteousness. If he or she received 300 out of 990 in TOEIC test, it doesn't matter. When the person does the right things, it is okay for him to do his work. It doesn't matter by other judgment. Church should be a place for disciplines, not for the test. Until he or she performs the best with effort, it can be fined for him or her. Jesus said, I'll tell you, not seven times, but 77 times. Genesis chapter 9, verse 1, Then God blessed Noah and his sons, saying to them, Be fruitful and increase in number and fill the earth. But the same verse was appear in Genesis chapter 1. God said Adam first. Then God said, Be fruitful and increase number and fill the earth. God blessed Noah and gave him the second chance. We receive a lot of graces from God. As we get older, we receive a lot of powers from others. At this time, people who receive grace from God, we try to give others more chances to do better. I will introduce a writer. His name is Hee-seok Kim. He had written a book which is named A Gift of Opportunity. I get these words from the book, so I used today as a topic. In the story, he received a phone call from a publishing company.
그렇죠. 그러다 보니까 자기 마음 가운데 고통도 있고
They suggest to him to write a book. Mr. Kim accepted the suggestion and tried to write, but he had no idea what to write. So he felt embarrassed and guilty. So what he did, he ran away. After a few years, he got a phone call from the same company. The manager of the company said, I want to give you one more chance. He had a hope to write, so he tried to write a book with his effort. The manager encouraged him to write again. People like to make their own judgments to be right. How come he wrote the book? Because he received the second chance. So he got encouragement so he can do best. The evil pushes us to make more sins. He tried to push us to be right. From this, we cannot judge which is right or wrong. We're trying to follow other saying, and we perform what other people say. We need to make the right things, not follow others. Most people push others to be on their side, and they judge others about what they have. We are sinners. We can be servants of the evil when you follow other saying. What do we do? We must be carefully. If you do not have any confidence, please do not speak and be quiet. According to your standard, please do not evaluate others. When someone has bad personality, we cannot say that he or she is right or not. Some people say, you are a child of God. How come you act like that? Other people like to evaluate others. They trying to show their ideas to be right, but it is their way. If someone has small eyes or big eyes, it is not good for us to say. We cannot talk of others' physical or facial appearances. What is the most important one? When you judge others, they feel a sense of shame or might listen to us. This time, we can say, I have power to speak. When people judge others in their way, they trying to be sure they are right, and they push them to do in their way. I never ask people about their educational background. I just ask about the name of their high school. And when they come to church, I do not want to ask about their education and background. When you heard that somebody who are from the famous university, some people think they are really smart. But when he or she studied in a university, which we never heard the name of the university, some people think the person didn't study hard. People like to talk about others' education background or physical appearances. They love to make gossips. But
입 다물고 있어야 됩니다.
We have to be careful to speak. When we start to judge others, we cannot stop. We receive the Holy Spirit, and we need to speak carefully. We do not have to follow other saying. We should not judge others in their ways. So what do we have to do? The evil pushes us to judge. When you start church, we're trying to make people feel shame, and we think we have power to speak others. But later, we can make them end their life.
그래서 주변 있는 사람을 다 죽이고 나중에 자기도 죽는
Even we followed what we said. We need to have blessings and graces from God. We have to pray that God, I want to follow what you have done. Please give me the one more chance to do better. Matthew chapter 18, verse 6. But if anyone calls one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him to have a large millstone hung around his neck and to be drawn in the depths of the sea. When you blame others, people surround me might get heartbroken. We need thank God with Him. We need to thank God. He already gave me more chances. We know the story about the parable of the unmerciful servant. A man who owed him 10,000 talents was brought to the master, and the master took pity. So he canceled debt and let him go. Like him, we must forgive others. Forgiving others is important, and he or she gives a second chance. I want you to receive a second chance from him, and we need to give others as well. The second one is that we need to thank God that he allows me to speak words. In Colombia, there is a famous writer. His name is Gabriel Marcos. He had written 1,000 years over solitude, which gives the reader the warm heart. There are two types of story. The first one is that reading books gives us rationally. The second one is that it gives us the warm heart. I recommend the second one. When you read the books, it touches your heart and you might feel emotional feeling. Gabriel Marcos has written a lot of books, but one of his books touches our hearts. I would like to introduce one short story of him. The name of the book is called The Wife. From the story, a man got an accident from the ship. His wife had not received any news from him, but later she realized her husband was dead. His friend came to her to give comfort, but they slept. After a few days, her husband was back. She was shocked. She felt guilty about what she had done with his friend. She experienced guilty life for 10 years. She decided to tell him about the accident. She came to him and explained what she had done and had guilty to him. But the husband did not care and entered into the room. She was embarrassed because she did not tell him with her heart, but the man's attitude was different. Suddenly, she came to him then say, "Why didn't you shout me at all? I think you do not love me anymore. I think you shout him at me, but your attitude is different." The husband did not make her speak anymore. She realized that the husband didn't forgive her. Gerasier, as a writer, showed the definitions of the love. From the story, it shows that the man did not allow her to speak. The definition of love is that when he or she allows a person to speak, this is a true love. Like the man, when the person doesn't allow others, this means that the person is like Pharisees. John chapter 8 is a woman in adultery. Pharisees brought her to Jesus. In a society, Pharisees brought her to Jesus. In a real world, most people come to her and ask, "Why did you do that? How come you did that?" People like to laughing at her, but this is the way, the word. But church members do not do that. Jesus is different. Jesus bent down and started to write on the ground with his finger. He said, "If any one of you is without sin, let him be the first to throw a stone at her." People began to go away. John chapter 8, verse 10 to 11. Jesus asked her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" She said, "No one." He said, "Then neither do I condemn you." Jesus declared, "Go now and live your life of sin." From these verses, we can see Jesus' attitude, which is the right things about the love. He forgave her and let her speak a word. Jesus asked, "Has no one condemned you?" Then she said, "Word, no one." Jesus tried to make her speak. From the main passage, Peter denied Jesus. We can ask him, "How come you did that to Jesus? Why did you blame him?" Maybe people in the world ask these questions, so it might make him get embarrassed. Probably Peter cried out and he regrets what he had done. But Jesus performed differently. John chapter 21, verse 15. When they had finished eating, Jesus said to Simon, "Peter, Simon, son of John, do you truly love me more than this?" He asked Peter with a present verse. He didn't ask the past things, what Peter had done. Jesus didn't ask like, "Did you love me?" But what Jesus asked, "Do you love me now?" Jesus talked about now, not the past.
위로해 줬다는 거예요. 더 확신을 줬다는 거예요.
Peter denied Jesus three times.
마음이 다 무너지고 아파 있습니다. 그래서 한 번 얘기가 진담인가요? 또 확인해 주고 또 확인해 줘 가지고
He regretted what he had done.
세 번 부인했기 때문에 세 번 물어본 게 아니에요.
Jesus came to Peter and asked three times. Do you love me now? Then Peter answered yes. I do. You know that. Our God gives us comfort and confidence. This is love. We need to make people speak more. I'll give you more examples. There is a girl who did not perform her best on a test. When she came in, her sister or brother blamed her about the test. She came into the room, but she was in more than 3 hours. She was sorrowful in the room because her sister or brothers shouted, Why didn't you study more? But she did not want to say any words. People trying to speak with the true things, but when you talk about the true story, but we cannot be saved. We have a sin, so we cannot show the true things at all. Her mother knocked the door and then asked, Aren't you starving? There is a sound from the room. The girl said, No, I do not want. The mother asked again, Aren't you thirsty? Then she said, No, I'm not thirsty. From the mother's questions, it makes her speak and answer those questions. After half an hour, she was in the kitchen and was eating. Jesus helps us to speak more. This is the love of father or mother. We have to have the love for others. When you try to help others to speak, it can be the love. This is our life. Today is Thanksgiving Day. But when you thank God,
내가 받았던 은혜에 대한 감사가 있어야 된다는 것입니다.
We can give others more chances to speak and forgive them.
사명을 연결됩니다. 나도 다시 기회를 주는 사람이 되기
바랍니다. Our God always gives us the second chance to help me. This can be your mission and He allows me to speak. I want you to be the servant of God. Let's pray. Thank you so much for giving me another chance to do your work and you allow me to speak the word. Let's pray.